Excuse me, are you Seth?
Who are you?
I'm a friend of Mr. West Dickens. My name's Marston. John Marston.
Goodbye, John Marston. It's been a great pleasure.
I need your help, Seth. We need your help. Me and Mr. West Dickens.
Let me be frank for 1 second, partner. I hate people. It was people who got me in this mess in the first place.
What mess?
Look at me. Look, scrambling around, looking for maps, half insane. I ain't washed in 6 months. My hair falling out, my mind's going.
What happened?
What happened? My partner, he stole half my map. I never would have done that to him. Never. Look at me.
Who did this to you?
My partner, my boy, my man, Moses Ford. I don't have the facility to tell you what I would have done for that man and what I would do to him now.
Why?
Because he stole half my goddamn map.
And what map's that then?
The map, partner. The map that tells me where it is.
Where what is, friend?
I ain't telling you that. I ain't. Don't make me tell, partner. It's mine. It's mine. All mine.
Sure. And where's this Moses now?
He's at Benedict Point. The law got him for exhuming. Some people, they feel differently. Not Moses. Him and me are the same. The self-same.
Well, come on, Seth. Let's go see Moses. Get you your map back. Then maybe you'll help me.
All right, partner. Let's go.
Horses are over here!
How can you sink that low? Digging up graves and looting from the dead.
Ha, hypocrite. The whole damn lot of you. Are you saying it's better to steal from the living? They're corpses. They don't care none.
These people have been laid to rest.
You don't know nothing. I talk to them long after they've been forgotten by every other fella. I tell them it's all right to be scared and alone. I embrace them when they're stinking and rotten.
I met some sick bastards in my time, Seth. But you, you're special.
Folk is cold and heartless all their lives. To me, they gets warmer when they're actually cold and heartless. Surely that makes sense to even you.
Not exactly, it don't.
Are we really living anyway? Do you exist outside my mind? Maybe we're both having the same dream, and when we wake up, we'll die.
I certainly seem to be in some kind of nightmare.
Looked in the cave, Seth?
It's very dark.
What'd you say?
I didn't say nothing.
I just heard you say something.
You're a crazy man. You should get that head looked at.
Seth, I need someone who can get a wagon inside Fort Mercer. I was told you could help me, but I'm not sure you even know what day it is.
I don't. I can't even tell you what year it is.
I knew this was a waste of time.
So, you want to go after Bill Williamson, do you?
You know Bill?
Oh, yes. I met Williamson and Deke and all them boys. Sometimes they call me on when they get some special job needs doing. I got a reputation as a man who do things most other fellers won't.
Now, that I can believe.
I reckon you can get in there, no bother. Assuming you help me find this map, that is.
What's so important about this map?
Nothing much. Just unimaginable riches and such like. A spark of hope that lit a raging fire I can't put out.
I thought as much. Another treasure hunter losing everything in the search for nothing.
Oh, I lost it all, partner. My wife, my children, my business. Good riddance to them all. I don't eat, I don't sleep, I don't wash, and I don't care.
I know.
I can smell you from here.
It used to be about the money, but now I don't know who I am no more. I see myself, but it's like I'm looking at somebody else. Only it's me, you know?
Maybe it's time you moved on.
Whoa, there! All right, this is it. Let's stop here a moment and come up with a plan. As far as I know, Moses is being held in that shack. There's a couple of deputies keeping guard outside. Can you distract him so I can sneak in for a quick parlay with that son of a bitch?
I'm sure I can think of something.
Lead them away from the shack and out of sight.
This is one god-awful assignment.
Stay away from them animals! Take your punishment like you deserve!
Come on! Let's go!
Good job getting rid of them clowns. Now keep an eye out in case they come back. Moses? Oh, Moses! You got a visitor!
Oh my God, Seth. They arrested me. It weren't my fault. Ah! Get the hell away from me!
Get that slippery bastard! I need him alive, though!
What's this got to do with you? Don't trust Seth! He's sick in the mind! could sell his own mother. You must be stupid trusting that crazy bastard.
Come on.
We'll split it between us, just me and you. Moses, you son of a bitch. Where's my damn map?
Damn you, Seth. Damn you, Seth. You've always been a twisting little freak. I ain't telling you shit.
Then I'm gonna cut you up piece by piece. Till you find your tongue.
Friend, this man's gone crazy in the sun. I suggest you take my advice and start talking.
Shut up, Marston. I want to cut into a bona fide man's flesh. Ain't never cut into a live one before.
Odd fellow's rest. It's an odd fellow's rest. Get away from me once and for all.
Well, ain't that a damn shame? I was starting to enjoy myself. I think you gone pissed yourself, Moses.
Those deputies went and put a bounty on your head. Best we clear it now. Don't need the law on our backs. I don't have no money, but I got me a pardon letter. Here, take it. You earned it for helping me with the Moses. Come on. We can pay it off in the telegraph office. Come on. Ain't no time to be wasting. Go speak to that fella. Let's get this over with.
I've learned the errors of my ways.
I hear they found some treasure.
Hurry up, will you? We got more important business to attend to.
Hey, partner.
Well.
So, mister, thanks for your help.
Don't worry yourself with thanks, Seth. Just help me when I come asking.
No problem, mister.
Faster!
Howdy, sir. Hola.
Better off riding with me, mister.
Morning, sir.
Face. How wonderful. Marvelous. My, my. Take a look at you. Will you take a look at you? You look like you've seen trouble, mister. Enough for 100 men.
Trouble has a way of finding me, mister.
Do I like the sound of that? Do I ever like the sound of that? Trouble with a capital T. That's just capital.
Whatever you say.
Cold. Tough, but with a heart of gold. The cowboy sings his lonely song, like a dog whose bone is made of wood.
Excuse me?
Oh, nothing. I was just writing my next piece. I've been sent out here to provide a little frontier joie de vivre for the ladies back east.
I don't understand a word you're saying, mister.
Yeah, my ma felt the same way. And now she wrote me out of her will, and there's no hope for any of us. Jimmy Saint, sir, at your disposal. But please don't dispose of me just yet.
What are you doing out here, Jimmy?
Capturing the spirit of the West for a monthly back east. You know, I'm sending them my oh-so-witty and oh-so-pertinent missives and gaining myself a little prize in the bargain. So it's action I'm after, and action I'm gonna find, too. Wild men, cheap women, you know, guns, that sort of thing.
Well, you have fun.
Fun? I'm gonna have the time of my life, sport. I tell you, mister, the time of my little old life.
Now, Mr. Marston. How are you, sir?
I'm all right. I met up with your friend, Seth.
Oh, Seth of the Dead. Yes, interesting fellow. You don't meet many men these days with the moral fortitude to cut straight to the chase like that, do you?
Thankfully not, Mr. West Dickens.
Yes, contemporary society is remarkably harsh on professional exhumers. But did you know that in ancient Egypt, it was an art form valued more highly than literature? I believe Seth comes from that school of thought.
How very interesting. Look, you thought any more about our plan?
Ah, your plan, dear boy, your plan. I am merely the help, not mercifully the arbiter of wisdom.
What you are, dear boy, is the man whose life I've saved twice now. A man who sells lies and deceit to unwitting people. A man who, if he doesn't help me, I won't think twice about putting a bullet through his skull, feeding to the vultures myself.
You see, Mr. Marston, you have the exterior of a violent man, but the soul of an angel, and that is what I think I cherish most about you.
That's what I thought.
But before we can attend to your particular problems, we need some extra lubricant to oil the machinery of business. And this being America, that lubricant with which we concern ourselves is money.
Money? What are you talking about?
Oh, we need weapons. Armor plate for the wagon, extra hands, and I need some danger money.
So, let's sell some more of these cures.
Sell cures? Around here? Do you want to see me lynched? No, the sport of kings. Racing, my friend, the sport of kings. A noble activity without reproach. Exactly the kind of activity where a lying, cheating, degenerate like myself can prosper. But come, let's finish the loading and we'll discuss it as we drive. Now, sir, two gap tooth breach.
Seth is an interesting fellow, is he not?
I wouldn't say interesting, more deeply disturbed. I can see why you two get along.
I see the good in everybody, John. It's a flaw of mine. I have a soft spot for life's flotsam and jetsam.
Connection with him, more like. You and Seth have a lot in common. You both rob people, for one. Mind you, at least he waits until they're dead.
Oh, my dear boy. Nobody is more critical of drinkers than a drunk who's mended his ways.
What are you talking about?
Come on now, John. I've heard about you. You spent your life robbing people. It's a little inappropriate to be taking the moral high ground now.
I had the courtesy to put a gun in their face.
Whatever helps you sleep easily at night.
We stole from those who had too much. Tried to give to those who had too little.
A Robin Hood with spurs. Oh, romantic. You expect me to believe that, poppycock? Maybe I'll have the good fortune to be able to leave my nefarious life behind one day and work on the government's dime.
Don't talk about things you don't understand.
Dear, oh dear, simmer down, my boy. You need to start appreciating your friends more. Folks around here don't see you as any different from Bill Williamson.
I didn't think I'd have to huckster snake oil and dig up the dead, that's all.
Take it from me, John. Collaboration is the key to success. I can help you. Seth can help you. It's business. Nothing more, nothing less. There's no need to make it quite so personal.
Suits me.
Anyway, John, we must talk about the race.
Yes, the race.
Oh, come on. start thinking like a winner. You're going to have a whale of a time. They've been holding these chariot races in New Austin for as long as I can remember. And we need the money.
Why aren't you racing then?
Me? Oh no, not my thing at all. You have already proved yourself more than adept at the reins, my dear boy, and under some stress. These races are Byzantine in their ferocity, and the terrain is treacherous. People will do just about anything to win. Men die. It's a marvelous spectator sport.
Sounds like fun.
And you are my wild card, John. They won't be expecting you.
So what's your role in all this?
Think of me as your spiritual guide.
Do I have to?
You are a free man, of course, but I strongly recommend it. Imagine, just for today, you are not an aging bounty hunter, and I am not an avant-garde business pioneer. No, sir. Today, we are gladiators. Motivation, dear boy.
I'm definitely feeling motivated to get the hell out of here.
I'll take care of this cart for Mr. West Dickens.
Come on, John. I suggest we beat a hasty retreat. Right.
Well done, sir. Well done. Having you as a ringer has netted us a fine profit.
We seem to be wasting time, old man.
Oh, patience, my friend. The Trojan horse cannot run before it can walk, if you'll forgive the metaphor. Next, we need to procure some grand and overwhelming firepower. And for that, you need to contact an old friend of mine. Goes by the name of Irish.
Irish?
Yes, he's an interesting kind of fellow. He usually can be found in Armadillo or some other town around here on some Bacchanalian revel or such.
Great. An alcoholic arms dealer.
What could be better? Mr. Marston, sir, John Marston. Mr. Marston, don't be so childish. Come on, sir, I implore you. Okay, so I made a few innocent mistakes when last we met, but my plan is still sound. Together we can conquer, if not the world, then certainly Bill Williamson.
But first, you need me to do you a favor?
You read my mind. I can only deduce you have been taking my tonic, sir, as instructed. It can give the most ordinary of intelligences a remarkable insight.
I'll give you insight. I'll show you what your guts look like.
Please, sir, this show of petulance is nothing short of embarrassing. Think for a moment, sir. Think.
I'm thinking about how much of my time you're wasting.
Sir, I am about to do something which I greatly discourage in all wise and rational men. A selfless act for you. But, sir, before I act selflessly, allow me to act selfishly and sell some of my wares.
Fair enough.
Oh, good, sir. Come, and let's go visit some of our fine friends in the other oil business we have here in Plainview. These men need all the help they can get.
Ladies and gentlemen, gather round. My friends, are you ready to change your lives forever?
Friends, hardworking souls of Plainview, do you suffer from rheumatism, lumbago, acute chronic sciatic, neurologic, or inflammatory pain? Well, I represent the only company that makes the genuine article which cures headache, neuralgia, toothache, earache, backache.
This man is a fucking charlatan. He just got done swindling us down at Cho Springs with this song and dance.
I say we tar and feather him right now.
I say we shoot the bastard.
I think it's time we take our business elsewhere. I apologize if science is not your forte. Good day, one and all.
Somebody get that thing back.
St. Homobonus is not going to be down on me favorably.
Who?
Homobonus, the patron saint of businessmen.
I'd say he's giving you your just desserts.
No, poppycock. Those inmates are clearly informed of my refund policy.
You can only shit on people for so long before they decide it's their turn to pull down the pan.
A crude metaphor in every sense of the word, my dear boy. You leave the business to me. Do I try to tell you how to rob banks?
Robbing banks no more honest than this.
Sure is lucky you came along when you did.
Lucky for who?
That's it! This is a terrible... Yes! We got him!
Looks like the global expansion of your West Dickens elixir might have come
from. Nonsense! Your super feathers, pump-pump science, rock you well. Look to the front, John!
Well, this sure is pleasant!
The road looks clear! Let's push out this way, Mr. These numbskulls expect miracles.
Well, that's about what you've been promising them.
Stay alert. I'm not sure we're out of the woods yet.
For a man of the people, you sure ain't very popular.
I am up against the wind.
Change of career.
I will never give up on science, John. these people harbor such bitterness?
Well, I ain't surprised. That tonic got you like a drink.
There's Quebececa up ahead. Well, that was a little hairy. Thank you, my dear boy. You saved the day again.
Me with the speed with which a group of men can turn from passive sheep into murderous wolves.
I'm impressed with how you nearly got us killed back there.
Yes, perhaps we should shelve the tonics business for a period.
Let's say we try our hand at racing again. There's a meet at Rathskeller.
You're trying my patience, Mr. West Dickens.
Well, I'm sorry, dear boy, but I'm only an aging vendor of exotic elixirs, not the bloody U.S. Cavalry. Forgive me if matters take some time to prepare.